意大利男子贝里沙娶了来自阿尔巴尼亚的穆斯林妻子瓦尔波纳，两人婚后定居米兰郊区，生了三个小孩，没想到平静幸福的生活逐渐变调。
She was a normal woman, Muslim, but not practicing. She didn't pray and she dressed in a Western style. Then she started to change the way she dressed and started to pray.I noticed that she was spending all of her time on the computer or looking at her phone.
一天早上，瓦尔波纳跟贝里莎说要跟朋友一起出门。直到当天傍晚，贝里莎接到女儿电话，才知道妻子离家。
At 5:30, my daughter called to say, "Mom's still not home." Called and called, but she never picked up. My daughter went into our bedroom and said, "Dad, all of Mom's clothes have gone."
贝里莎报案之后，警方从机场监视录影器发现她带着六岁的儿子从米兰飞往土耳其伊斯坦堡。三天后，她才收到太太的讯息，说她人到了叙利亚。意大利警方随后证实，瓦尔波纳已经加入叙利亚的逊尼派恐怖组织伊斯兰国。他显然是在浏览好几百个伊斯兰激进组织的宣传影片之后受到影响。意大利警方还曾经在2016年击毙攻击德国柏林耶诞市集的嫌犯。24岁的图尼西亚籍嫌犯艾姆里之所以能够掌握到他逃到意大利的行踪，是因为意大利警方长期监听当地一个专门伪造证明文件、提供预付卡电话、国际银行转账资料的犯罪集团首脑亚历山大。
The investigation revealed that Annie Samri had met with people here in Italy, some of whom are dangerous because they're radicalized.
资料显示，意大利有大约130人被伊斯兰激进组织吸收，但目前意大利并未成为恐怖攻击目标，引发其他欧洲国家好奇。专家认为，跟意大利警方长期跟黑手党交手有关。在2016年时，意大利反恐部门盘查了超过16万人，其中3万4000人在机场就被拦下，550名恐怖嫌犯被逮捕，其中38人被判刑。反恐单位还关闭了500多个激进网站，并持续监控近50万个恐怖网络。
Jihadist organizations are involved in the trafficking of drugs, arms, archaeological artifacts, diamonds, and black market oil. They sell all that throughout Europe by dealing with the mafia organizations here.
另一方面，相较于法国、英国和比利时，意大利的移民第二代并不多，当局不用应付大量有激进化风险的人群。反恐专家表示，全天候监控一名恐怖嫌犯大约需要20个人力，人数越多挑战越大。记者陈秋梅报道。